Welcome back to the Middle-earth Shadow of War Gravewalker difficulty walkthrough, where we'll complete the entirety of the Karnan questline, get our Drake pet, and level up nearly to level 40. And Karnan's Bane over here is our destination. This is a fun quest. Before we do that, though, what we're going to do is, as soon as we get over and just before we start the quest to give us the longest possible time with boosted XP, we'll use one of our XP boosts. This first Karnan quest doesn't give that much XP. I've got plenty of XP boosts from Nemesis, so I'm just going to use it through the entire quest line. If you want to wait a little bit until some of the later quests, then that makes sense too if you've only got like one boost. Act 3 is another really, really good time to be using these XP boosts. Okay, Karnan's Bane. The trick with this one is to... Oh, actually, before we get into it, one more thing.
It's yours.
Failed to mention this. So I've equipped the wealth gems in my armor and my cloak to get the extra XP boost, too. So we're a little bit more squishy. Should be okay, but just... You know, you want to get as much XP off of these as you can so that you get as close as possible to level 50 by the end of the questline. Karnan's Bane is an awesome quest. It's the first time you'll be facing the Balrog in the game, and who doesn't want to take down the Balrog, right? Like, coolest monster in the Tolkien universe, I think. The key to this one is really just following the prompts. It's not too difficult, even on Gravewalker, so we should be able to get through fairly easy. So basically all I was trying to do there was get up on top of these so that you can take out the archers more easily. Don't really want to have to deal with any of this stuff down below. So you can see I'm replenishing my elf shot before I kill these guys. Take out the other ones from up here, too. And, you know, I could just charge down, kill them, all of that, but I just like to play it safe.
What an honor to meet the most famous dead man in Mordor. You really shook the world with that ring-forging trick of yours. After that, Targaroth only needed a little coaxing. Now, it rises to the surface, and it comes for you.
Zog.
So the fear of burning is probably your easiest way to take this guy down quickly, and this is how.
Don't be sad. It doesn't end here. I will wake all the dead of Mordor before we're done. All the lives you ended. And once they're risen, who do you think they'll come for? Oh yes, we'll meet again.
Swallowed by the darkness!
Talion, it has begun. The Balrog is rising.
We'll not give it the chance.
You So here we go. Leap of faith time.
Celebrimbor, not with the spirit of Karnan at our side.
Woken by death ring, flames burn us. You woke him. You woke him.
Fire.
for you, no rest for we, Deathless One.
She is truly a power to be reckoned with.
The spirit of Karnan has witnessed Middle-earth's devastation and its revival many times over. She was here before any of us, and she will be here long after we have perished.
So as you can see, double the XP helped quite a bit in terms of skill points.
If we do not stop Torgoth, he will venture far beyond Mordor, to Rohan and Gondor.
That cannot happen.
So now that we are level 23, definitely pick up Ground Rain. And I would probably do Shadow Mount next. Okay, so we want to get over here to the Frozen Flame quest, and the quickest way to do that is to hop over to the, for whatever reason, this Haydir is open for me when I first get into the zone, so hop over to that one.
The Balrog will devour Middle-earth if we do not stop it.
No small task, but with Karnan we have a chance.
Nithon Ole Ionken!
While we're here, we'll reveal the collectibles, but we won't actually go out and get them until we get the Drake. Yeah. Frozen Flame is a really fun quest. During the initial part, you just follow the footprints and fire in the flaming buildings until you get to Targaroth, and then make sure you shoot down the stalactites. Basically, one arrow per group of two or three stalactites will bring them down and slow them. And then when you get to the lake, I'll tell you the strategy when we get there.
Targaroth fouls earth and sky, plows a path of flame. Haste, haste, haste! It rages across land, scorches a path.
Targaroth will not be difficult to find.
Escape with this Targaroth. Freeze Mordor to burn your lands.
That is the strategy for this part.
What did he say?
Does it matter?
This Balrog is from another world.
It is up to us now, Talion.
This isn't working!
We bring light to your abyss, an end to your fire.
So be sure to flap here to get additional speed. That way you stay ahead of his fireballs. And then when you get the X prompt, be sure to dive bomb him during. Almost didn't get that because I was talking. During the next phase, you'll want to get your frost up or your might up. When he does that, flat. Thank you.
attack.
So build up my fire or frost blast him, and then flap away. Dive bomb, rinse, repeat.
To that death.
Three skill points. So I think in the list I recommend getting the last chance, so we'll go ahead and get it. So if you get Adamant, you actually do get one last chance attempt in Gravewalker difficulty, so that helps quite a bit. And that's pretty much it for the build in terms of the skills that you'll need to get. I'll pick up other stuff as we go through from here on, but it's pretty much up to you what you want to get next. I like to upgrade my Drake next so that it can take more damage. So I'll get Dragon Rider and Scales of Iron. So that makes your Drake fairly durable, and Drakes that you tame out in the wild too. So we're back in Nernan now, and we'll move on with the next Karnan quest. So you can see we'll get 41k XP off of this one as well, which is a nice bump. Should get two or three levels off of that. See, I'm skipping into collectibles for now, just because we're on a timer with the XP buff. Okay, this one's pretty easy.
You have sacrificed much.
Long afore, buried was Torgoroth by Karnan in Doomshadow. Aghast, my forest destroyed, my brood scattered. Now again, fire is buried. Drowned in ice. And from decay come bloom. The circle is unbroken.
It was an Uruk in Gorgoroth. This Zog.
Chainer of Torgoroth. Death's midwife, raised Targoroth, raised Orklings.
A necromancer.
He is near. Stains air with orc magics. Cunning he, Dwimmercraft. Like tide waters, baseborn, beset by death. They come for you.
By my oath, we will find him and honor your sacrifice.
Fetter the fowl or return them to dust. Defiled is the land. Cursed is the Maker.
If Sauron can raise the dead.
This Zog cannot be far off.
This is Zog's disease. Bring him to rot!
At this point, you can charge over and attack all of that stuff, but if you want to do it easier, or if you're having problems, I'll show you another strategy based on our build. So eventually, as you kill these guys, you'll get rid of most of them over here just by using Shadow Strike Pull. Then when you pull Zog, all of the rest of them should come over. Try and leave one up that you can hit with Shadow Strike so that as Zog runs over this way, you can jump back over to the other side and get the statues down, or the pillars down, before he gets to you, and then he'll go running back to the other side.
Zog.
So there's Zog the Internal. So you're pulling him over to this side. When he gets a little bit closer, you go back to the other side.
Close and close, guys.
We will defend the master!
You're not fighting us, Ranger. You're fighting the future. The dead will take Mordor for themselves, and not even you can stop us. Oh, there's more fun to come.
Zog.
So he still has a fear of burning, so keep that in mind. If you were to go over and just fight him normally, when you destroy the pillar, he runs away. But if you were to go and charge all of the enemies, not the wisest idea in Gravewalker, but hey, you know, whatever floats your boat, then you'll want to be exploiting that burning. No need with this strategy, though.
This Zog is dangerous. His acolytes, perhaps more so.
We must track them down, wherever they are.
The next one I'd probably pick up now that you've got a stronger Drake once we finish the Karnan quests is Mindbreaker, so that'll let you dominate enemies more quickly. So it's easier to dominate captains in the middle of a pack of orcs.
Zog's acolytes have spread across Mordor.
And we will find them. All of them.
Why not? It was here. Of ghouls and grogs. So this one is not too difficult. I tend to stay back, take advantage of Shadow Strike Pull. And the other thing that you'll want to do, when I first tried this one on Gravewalker, my Karnan beast kept dying repeatedly. So basically I just kill the ghoul's nests with the beast and then park it somewhere safe and then go off and finish the quest on my own so that it doesn't die and you fail the quest and have to restart.
The Brothers of Corruption raise their dead face to face.
See how fearsome they are now.
Just destroying it fast while we're here.
It's time for them to feel some of their own.
The stench of death surrounds a confusion of ghouls. They rise and rise.
As they rise, so shall they fall.
Flee this corruption.
So you see the smoke on the ground? Those are the ghoul's nests. Just hit your attack button to take them out.
We must destroy the ghoul mounds. Only then will they stop.
clearing it out a little bit, make it safer for the mount. I tend to park him over here, where he's safe and he's not going to get killed for the next part. Because as you can see, there's a ton of enemies over there, so it's better for you to just go in on your own, believe it or not, because you risk having your mount killed otherwise. Shadow Strike, pull from here to take him out. Could use stealth too to get most of them. But you know me, I'm lazy.
danger!
We won't be able to end the ritual if we don't get through these ghouls.
Probably wouldn't get any closer than here with him. Looking for a good vantage point to use. I think I'll use the top of the buildings there. Not what I meant to do.
Thank you.
them by its corruption.
Our work continues.
These necromancers will not stop until all the dead of Mordor have been raised.
An army to rival ours.
Okay, next up I'd start working on the stealth tree. In particular, Wraith Chain is a lot of help and a lot of fun. As is Contagion, so if you want to sit back and just watch a camp destroy itself, this is, yeah, just poison a few grog barrels with this one active. Next up, on to Curith Ungol. So if you have it unlocked, the Hadir over here, then this is probably the easiest way to go. You just have to run across. I don't have that one unlocked, so I'm just going to move up from this one.
Take me without your pet to help you, weakling!
So this one's quite a bit of fun. Just need to take out the archers and try to avoid dying.
Rise.
I know, that comes as a shock to most of everybody, but hey.
Arise in haste! Archers are raised by Aphelios.
Who are these archers of Morgoth?
Morgoth was the first Dark Lord, and these archers, long dead, were one of his creations. They were masters of their craft, and cannot be allowed to escape these caves.
There they be.
We must destroy their totems before more of them rise.
Rise!
when I take a little bit of damage, I tend to use I tend to grab an enemy and consume him so that I get my health back up.
Trifka and Morgoth be damned. Find Zog and his acolytes, deathless swine. Cleanse them with fire and spare not a one.
Zog's ambitions will only increase.
We must find him before he raises his own army.
So with Wraith Chain, which is this one, the next upgrade that I'll grab when I get some more skill points is this Shadow Blade. So this will let you stealth kill 4 enemies in a row really quick, so that speeds up how quickly you can take out packs of enemies.
With each day, Zog's power grows.
And through each acolyte, he recruits more of the undead.
So the Burning Forest can be a little bit tricky. It's a lot easier if you can summon the Grog Mount, but if you can't, use the Caragor, try and keep the Caragor alive by eating the enemies, and yeah, just be careful of the archers.
They come for Karnan.
We must destroy their totems.
A waste to burn it all down.
The ability to scry.
Could the elves scry with such a bowl?
Yes, and doing so was safer than using a palantir, because the visions travel in only one direction.
Thank you.
can't do it.
So make sure your captain is with you. You need to kind of race against time at this point. You'll be killing enemies that are attacking the Great Tree. So it's, yeah, just try and stay mobile.
Who's the Gravewalker?
Has been cleared. They will not be back.
Cursed is Zog by furious hunger. A pact unfinished, he will raise Torgoroth.
Torgoroth is no more, you saw to that.
Put ear to earth and heed. Brothers of corruption hold gloaming vigil. Fire will rise from ice.
If Zog is able to raise the Balrog, it will be his thrall, and its power will be his. He must be stopped.
You're not coming with us, are you?
The long winter calls my name.
Okay.
Forests of Cornwall must rest in dwell. Cornwall, be still, or all is ash. The circle cannot be broken. Go now.
So from this point on, really, I don't have too many suggestions. I'll just be picking up things at random. You know, there are a lot of good abilities that are kind of helpful. Like Hammer of Eregion, for example. If, as you leap over stuff, you'll freeze it, so you don't have to leap and then freeze them with an attack. You freeze them automatically, and then you can go right into a critical chain. But it's really up to you at this point. The build's pretty much complete. We're just trying to get the Drake mount, which we'll get after the next quest, I believe. So yeah, it's pretty much just grab whatever you think you want to play around with. Some of the abilities that I really like, though, are the ones that let you use your abilities against Olugs. So this one here, Olug Lord, and Savage Ice. Both of those, I tend to keep those slotted so I just don't have to worry about whether something will work against an Olug High or not. The other set worth picking up is the Poison Blast for Elden Light, as well as Final Blaze and Poisonous Wrath for the end of Elden Rage. You can see currently I'm not using Elden Rage all that much. Later on, when we get the Bright Lord set, which again I recommend you wait to do the Bright Lord set quests until you're level 60, but once we get the Bright Lord equipment, we'll be able to generate Wrath a lot more quickly. So, you know, we'll use Elven Rage a lot more, and in which case this ability will come in handy. So it's not a priority right now, but it'll come in handy later. So I think for this one right now, I'll just pick up the hammer. Actually, I changed my mind. We'll get the Grog mount just so we have it in case we need it. And then maybe we'll go for hammer next. So the next quest that we're going to do is Fire from Ice. We'll get the Dragon Song skill upgrade as well as a ton of XP. But before we do that, we haven't really done a whole lot in Cerghost. I took a minute to unlock the Haydir over here, which is the shortest point to get over to the quest. And the other thing that we'll want to do is just really quickly spend some of the Mirian that we have and get ourselves a bodyguard for Cerghost, because we don't have one here. We haven't assigned one at all, so let's do that.
If Zog is able to raise Tar-Goroth, he will be unstoppable.
Well then, we must kill him before.
So you can see just by playing through and you know, dismantling equipment that we get over time and picking up the Mirian. When we see it, I'm up to 24,000 Mirian. That's enough for me to buy 10 of the silver war chests, which can also drop legendary orcs, but either way, we'll just buy 10 of those really quick. And see what we get. We got an Ep, then we got a normal guy. Be nice if we got a legendary too, but I don't. They're pretty rare from the silver chests. Thank you. Okay, let's see what we got. So we want to pick sort of the most durable, damaging orc that we have out of these chests to be our bodyguard. And we'll look for somebody who isn't mortally vulnerable to anything, won't get dazed by anything, and pretty much like is only vulnerable to stealth, ideally. And if you can get somebody who's immune to arrows, makes it even better. So you don't want Kraven, obviously, because he'll run away immediately at the beginning of the fight. And if any of his pets are going to get killed, he's weak, so he'll get dazed. So just go through, see what you get, look for somebody who's kind of ideal. This guy isn't too bad, he's only afraid of spiders, so he's worth keeping around. He's also poison proof, so we could give him a poison weapon and he'll be really good. This guy would be great if he didn't get dazed when rage drops off. He's got two immunities too, so that's pretty helpful, but because of that daze, we don't want to use this one. So this guy is pretty awesome. The other orcs won't be able to execute him. He's immune to curse, so we can give him a curse weapon, and he's only vulnerable to stealth, so we'll go with this guy. Most likely, but let me check the other ones just in case. Yeah, another good guy here, and he will be pretty effective because he's a feral slayer, so he'll do a lot of damage. And because he's fireproof, we could give him a fire weapon if we wanted, so this is another keeper. Fireproof and poisonproof, and no weaknesses. So, very good guy to use here as well. Okay, so for what we have, I think this guy is going to be the best. He's vulnerable to stealth, but who cares? The best thing about him is that he is immune to execution and to curses, so when the other orcs try to execute him, he's not going to take any damage from it. So that makes him a bit more durable. Plus, he's an Olog, so he's got more health. Thank you. he's got a gang of archers with him too. That'll be a little bit problematic for him if he's in the fight pits. As an Olok, he'll get hit in the back a lot by his own archers. But, you know, we can always change the gang of archers to something else. Deploy him fast, and you'll notice, here's another tip for you, we don't have the intelligence for most of the Org captains in this area, but what we can do is we can deploy all of our own Orcs, and they'll just take over for the most part as long as they win the duel, then they'll replace the other Org captains. So that's a pretty good way to take over a new zone if you want to. So let's go ahead and put out some more orcs after we appoint our bodyguard.
Ur-Gram.
So he's our bodyguard now, and if you have it, so this guy is immune to curse, so let's give him a curse weapon if we can.
Ur-Gram.
I'm also going to give him something other than the archers.
Ur-Gram.
Kind of like the savages, so we'll give him some savages. Now I'd love to give him Curse Master, but we don't have it. So I'll make him epic with Mighty Savages. So he should be pretty effective at this point. I'm quite happy with that. So let's deploy some of the other orcs that we have, and we'll just deploy them randomly.
Ur-Gram.
So as you can see, this will save you a whole lot of time. You don't have to go out and kill all of the captains or dominate all of them. You can just replace them as long as you've got the Mirian to do it. So as you can see, it just took a few minutes to make the entire army and the entire field blue. So that'll make it safer for me when I'm running around trying to pick up the collectibles and everything. Shouldn't get surprises too unless the outlaw tribe or somebody tries to ambush me. So just, you know, makes things faster. It's not mandatory for you to do this by any means. If you've got the Mirian though, you might as well do it. Okay, let's continue on with the quest. Oh, one more thing. You'll notice I won all of the duels there. I can't swear to it, but I think it's because of the gem that I have slotted. So this one increases follower damage by 25%, so I think that's enough to tip the scales in the advantage of the ones that we're deploying
I don't know if that's the case or not. I haven't tried doing this method without that gem slotted, but I pretty much win every duel that I engage in when I'm deploying new orcs. So I would recommend slotting this gem or the next level or whatever. Just slot a warrior gem in your ring slot before you start doing all of that.
This is it.
Fire from Ice can be a really challenging quest. Zog can nearly one-shot you. So what you're going to want to do is pull him over to the side, over by the keep, go back over, get rid of the totems. If he comes back over to you, run back over to the keep area, pull him back over there, then Shadow Strike back over to get more of the totems. Until all the totems are down, then you've got Zog alone. That's when you'll summon your captain. And your Grog or your Caragor if you have them, and try and take out Zog. It's a really challenging fight though, but hey, at the end of it we get Dragon Song and a bunch of XP, so let's do it.
The ritual has commenced.
We can waste no time.
Argoroth! We call you back from your tomb! Rise and join our glory!
It's working!
Targaroth lives! It lives!
Targaroth will rise, but not for Sauron. He will fight in my army, a legion of the dead that will rival any army of Mordor. You will hear them when they come, for they will chant my name. Zog! Zog! Zog!
Zog.
Thing still. Fear of burning and flammable, so that's what we'll exploit when we fight him. For now, though, we're just going to keep taking out the totem, so try not to get hit by Zog and keep your health up, and then we'll take him out in a little bit. Try and keep walls between you and Zog too. If he's able to see you, he can either kill you or get you close to dying, and more than likely or not, he'll curse you. So
Just try and keep walls between you and him when you're pulling him back to this side.
To pull life from death, and you ended it! He was to be my masterwork, and you ended it! This is how you die, Gravewalker!
Zog.
Alright, so now we want to pull our captain out, our Graug out, and try and set him on fire if we can.
I serve, Bright Lord!
We did it.
Then Kanan's sacrifice was not in vain.
And there we go. Dragon Song is ours. This would be a good time to stop, go around, get all of the collectibles, all the extra skill points, unlock anything that you want, make sure that you get all of the intel as you're going through, you know, kill treasure orcs, all of that. I'll show you guys really quickly the strategy for farming using the Drake. This will make things a lot faster though. So we've got the hammer of Aragon, as I was saying last time.
So Drake thinks...
We're flying!
Sauron's domain is now much smaller.
So Drake makes everything a lot faster for farming, and I'll show you why really quick. Go. So you can just fly around, jump off the Drake when you see something you want to kill or pick up, then go back to the Drake, remount using Shadow Mount. So it makes things really quickly when you're trying to go around and farm stuff. Okay, let's move on to the next quest. So one of the things that you'll notice is that the Drake is not summonable in Minas Morgul. So that's why I suggested we go out and grab all of the collectibles here, because you can't use the Drake. All of the other zones, though, you can use the Drake. So at this point, it makes sense to go pick up all of the collectibles. But since we've got the XP buff running, let's finish off Army of the Dead first. Army of the Dead. This quest can be very, very difficult if you don't have Shadow Strike Pull. If you do have Shadow Strike Pull, it'll make things a lot easier. You'll also want to make sure that you've set yourself up with a bodyguard. And in fact, let me check if we have. So we don't have a bodyguard, so I'm going to set myself up with a bodyguard really quickly. Hopefully he'll be able to survive. I don't know if he's any good or not, but he'll do for now. He's not going to get pinned here, and there will be no Caragor, so he will do fine. Because he's got those two weaknesses, though, I'm not going to bother upgrading this guy at all. He's just fodder for now. Army of the Dead, again, we'll use Shadow Strike Pull to isolate the enemy captains. One of the best things about doing it early on like this is that the enemy captain levels should all be lower. Otherwise, it's even more difficult, but it'll take a while. We'll isolate each of the captains, kill them off, destroy their totem, rinse and repeat it, and then finally move on to fighting Zog last.
Look around you. The orcs who took this city. This is our army. Not Sauron's. Not the Witch King's. The dominion of those slave masters is at an end. For today, we rise!
Zog's acolytes have been busy.
And a necromancer is never truly dead. Skoon.
The arena is stocked with dead Uruk, victims of the siege.
An army in waiting.
Skoon's back. No ambushing me with four people.
Finally!
Shaka.
Take me, Glob.
Okay then. Get our health shot and health back and get the next captain.
Gone.
Not you.
Clark.
Happy to see you too, buddy.
Tugog.
So Tugog is arrowproof. Not going to be able to separate him too easily, so we'll just polish up the other captains and then do the totems as best we can and then try and lure him and Zog away from the middle totem.
You could have died faster!
He is instantly killed by beasts, so conveniently located above him is something that'll summon some beasts. Unfortunately, it looks like the beasts did not get him, so we'll summon our Caragor and then pounce on him.
Oh.
basically right now I'm just trying to get him alone. One moment. Batteries on the controller went dead. We're back though. Okay, let's get him. Trying to get that last captain who's roaming around, but it looks like he's just wanting to wander in the back for a bit, so we'll take out some of the totems in the meantime. Actually, never mind, he should come into view in just a second. Out of the way, kitty. So that's everybody except for Zog and the captain in the middle. What we'll do now is we'll take out the totems except for the one in the middle, then pull those two away, then go down and get the middle one, then kill those two. just use the enemies to keep your elf shot topped up. Get hit, you can see they still do nearly half my health, so just back off, Shadow Strike, pull one to your top up, and keep going. Totem over on the far side looks a little more vulnerable, so we'll go get that one quick and then clear off this side.
Some of the others will say you should age your Caragor meat. I like to eat it fresh. Pressure. I try to eat Caragor meat. I shrug for days, non-stop. And everyone thought it was out of here.
So better angle on this side. Safety and next totem. So now I don't want to alert Zog and the other captain, so I'll stealth down to that totem.
Red sword.
hopefully my captain doesn't get killed. Looks like he's engaging, so we'll send the captain home for now, just to keep him alive. Looks like that pulled Zog and the other guy off to the side too, so that's kind of handy. So we'll go get the other two totems fast. So it's just us and Zog now. I'm going to wait for my captain to come back before I do this, because Zog can still hit damn hard and kill you in like one hit. And I'd rather not have him kill me outright. So I'll come back AFK for a little bit, come back when we're ready to kill him and we've got our captain. Okay, just a few more seconds on Zog. So let's check out his weaknesses. Basically, fire is the way we're going to want to go, but we're out of might because we waited for a while. Or maybe we didn't have might before I stopped.
Zog.
So he'll take a lot of damage from fire, so to the extent that there's fire around that we can use against him, we'll try and do that. And then we'll use our captain as well. He is not vulnerable, or he is not immune to arrows, so we can pull him next to something that we can use to explode and set him on fire to speed things up at the start. So that's what we'll probably do. So work to fire things that we can use to damage him. He's not actually immune to arrows. It's just that we haven't spoken with him yet. So I'll let him get angry with us.
We could have been allies!
That kind of spoils that plan, though. It's bizarre that he's still being sent as set as arrowproof, but he's not actually.
Just waiting for someone who will listen, who will answer their call. Once you're out of the way, we will all rise again.
We could have been allies. I like explosions.
It is Kanan.
To ash you go! Burn to cinder and to return!
I told you, Ranger, undead will defeat undead.
And that is the Kanan questline. Looks like we only got up to level 73 with it though, but, or 37 with it though, but still, that's really good progress. And then we can continue on with the other quests, but I think we'll end the video here.
I don't even realize how hard I work for them.
I'll just buy some points really quick. So we'll make sure that our freeze pin will affect Olokai now. As well as Olog Lord, so that our consume will work on Ologs. So your homework now is to go out and get all your collectibles and farm your gems up. I'm going to go do that in the other zones, and then we'll see you in the next episode, all topped up and ready to go for the next questline. One last thing before we go. Before I actually go out and farm gems, we're going to want to get this prospector ability, which we need to get all the Gondoran artifacts in order to get this one unlocked. So we'll do the first of the Gondorian quest line, which will get us the last Gondorian artifact that we need in order to unlock this before we go out and farm those gems. So I thought I'd add that to this video before people went out and spent a bunch of time farming gems when you could get higher quality gems if you wait just a little bit longer. So do that next episode after we've done that quest.